Alright, then we'll move that there, and then we'll move.
Oh, man, I'm getting tired.
Oh, no more coffee. That's not a good sign. Alright, just a little bit more. Little bit more. Little bit more. Oh, this looks comfy. I'll just rest for just 1 minute. Oh, hey guys! You look familiar! Why am I in my kids' TV show? You're Sky and Rocky and Rubble and Marshall and Chase and Zuma? Well, hi! I'm trying to find Elmonica for our assembly today. You guys think you can help me out? Ah, try something different.
Whoa. This is definitely not Elmonica.
Is this a bat cave? What kind of remote is this? Thank goodness I got teleported to an actually cool superhero movie. Huh. It would have been really awkward if I would have been teleported into that Disney Marvel trash. Anyway, I gotta get back to school. Oh, hey guys. Hey, I'm looking for Elmonica. Can you guys help me out? No? Gotta go! Assemblies, finds a way. Must go faster. Hey. I'm trying to find my way to, Elmonica. Any guys? Anyone? Anyone seen on the way to Elmonica? Hello? Hello? Daddy Chill. You know where Elmonica is? Hey. Question. Do you know where Elmonica is?
This is the way.
So this is the way? This is the way to Elmonica?
This is the way.
Right. Okay. I loved your cat. Oh my gosh, it was just a dream? It was just a dream. I'm on the air! Good morning, Elmonica engineers! It is I, Mr. Nelson, your student manager, and I'm coming to you live on this beautiful Wednesday morning. Today is October 28th, 2020. Not a whole lot's changed in the world. I'm still here at school, you're at home, but boy, do I have an assembly for you. Let's roll out, engineers. Come on!
Yo, Flo-Yo!
Yo-Yo!
Show us how you say hello!
I move like this and go with the flow, and then I say hey, hey, you know!
Hey, hey!
Hey, hey!
Hey, 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 hello! Yo, laser fresh!
Yo, yo!
We here!
Show us how you say hello!
We move like this and go with the flow, and then we say what's up,
what's up? Show us how you say hello.
I move like this and go with the flow, and then I say cheerio, you know.
Cheerio.
Cheerio.
Cheerio, cheerio.
Meow.
Yo, Squatchy.
Yo, yo.
Show us how you say hello.
I move like this and go with flow, and then I say aloha, you know.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Aloha, aloha, aloha. Yo, Moose Tube.
Yo, yo.
Show us how you say hello.
We move like this and go with the flow, and then we say
chow, you know.
Chow.
Chow. Ciao, ciao, hello! Yo, Maximo!
Yo, yo!
Show us how you say hello!
I move like this and go with the flow, and then I say hola, you know!
Hola!
Hola!
Hola, hola, hello! Yo, Elm!
Yo, yo!
Show us how you say hello!
I still like this and go with the flow, and then I say namaste, you know!
Namaste!
Namaste!
Namaste, 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 namakusa! Yo, Nod Dog!
Yo, yo!
Show us how you say hello!
I move like this and go with the flow, and then I say bonjour, you know, bonjour!
Bonjour! Bonjour, 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 hello! Yo, teacher!
Yo, yo! Show us how you say hello.
I move like this, I go with the flow, and then I say, what a do, you know, what a do, what a do, what a do, what a do, hello.
Yo, class, show us how you say hello. Hello, yo, everyone.
Yo, yo.
Show us how you say hello.
I move like this and go with the flow, and then I say, hello, you know.
Hello, hello, hello indeed! It is great to be back with our Go Noodle friends. Stay tuned for future months as we bust out some awesome brain breaks. Anyway, just like with the other assemblies, I like to start off with our Pledge of Allegiance. And this month, we've got our first grade team. Take it away, first grade!
Alrighty, let's begin! I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America,
and to the Republic for which it stands,
one nation under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
For the month of November, friends, I've got Mr. S and Miss Heatherly bringing you our music room and exercise of the month. Take it away, guys.
Hello, Elmonica Engineers. Your activity today is called Elmonica Engineers. And the way it works is simple. You're going to have two spaces, a front space and a back space. If you have a line to separate the spaces, that's fine. If you don't have a line, no problem. So the way it works, Elmonica is your front space. Engineers is your back space. When I say Elmonica, jump to the front space. When I say engineers, jump to the back space. Elmonica. Engineers. Elmonica. Engineers. Pretty simple, huh? All you have to do is follow along. The only rule is to keep your feet together. If you lose your balance and your feet come apart, or if you step, you're out. All right. Level one coming up. Get ready. Okay, are you ready? Here we go. Level one. Elmonica. Engineers. Elmonica, engineers, engineers, Elmonica, engineers, Elmonica, Elmonica, Elmonica. Pretty good. Here we go. Level two, a little bit faster. Elmonica, engineers, Elmonica, engineers. Elmonica, Elmonica, engineers, 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 Elmonica, engineers. Not bad. Level three. I'm usually a pretty nice guy, but I'm going to try and get you out. Here we go. Engineers, Elmonica, Elmonica, engineers, 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 Elmonica. Engineers, Elmonica, engineers, Elmonica, engineers, engineers, Elmonica, Elmonica. All right, Elmonica engineers, great job. Maybe I got you out. Hopefully I made you a little bit tired. Hopefully you have a great week. See you next time.
Hi, Elmonica engineers. Mrs. Heatherly here. This is my first time joining you in an assembly, so thank you for having me. All of the students at Elmonica have been working really hard to learn how to read and write and hear all of the rhythms that go with music. I'm really proud of the progress you all have been making. So here's your chance to show it off. Grab two pens or two pencils, grab two toys, or grab an item from your home that you can pat that makes a sound, and you're going to get to play along with the great Candy Hunt rhythm play along. Show your family or anyone who's in your home what great rhythm readers you are, and keep up the great work in music class. Bye, everybody.
Thank you.
Mr. S, Mrs. Heatherly, that was awesome. Thanks so much, and thank you all at home. I could hear so much of you practicing those rhythms on that spooky Halloween rhythm activity. Anyway, we're switching gears. We're going to take a look at last month's responsibility, and I'm going to send it over to Miss Alt for our responsibility student spotlight. Take it away, Miss Alt.
Cool. Hello!
Hello, everyone. I'm Kamachi from kindergarten.
Hi, friends. This is Snow from kindergarten.
Hi, I am Trinka.
My name is Gautam.
Being responsible is when doing the right thing when no one is watching.
I'm responsible in many ways.
At school, I raise my hand.
I'm responsible at home by doing all of my chores.
Listening to a teacher on Zoom meeting.
Doing all my chores at home independently. Attending all my Zoom meetings on.
I water my plants every day.
Daily morning, I do a small exercise and meditation, which helps me to focus on my activities.
I do chores around the house. I'm on time and I do my homework on time.
I keep my toys and stuff in the correct place after using them.
I do seesaw activity regularly.
I pay attention to my teacher, what they are saying.
And I feed my fish and I make sure that the water is clean for my fish.
Be on time. Listen to the teacher.
Finish all my activities on time.
I have completed my seesaw remox activities.
I listen to all my teachers carefully and wait for my turn.
Every Friday, I check the fridge and make up a grocery list. On Saturday, I remind my dad to get those things from Costco.
I follow the Zoom rules. I complete seesaw activities daily.
I do my assignments and work given by my teacher on time.
And I'm responsible at school by raising my hand and turning my work in on time.
I read some books in Epic 2.
Raise my hand when I need to talk. Get my homework done.
I do dream books and read on Epic.
And keeping myself safe outside.
That's how I can be responsible.
So be responsible. If you be responsible, you can always achieve your goal and do your things on time. Bye.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
You guys are truly rock stars. And we have more examples of how to show responsibility. Join us on a look at second and third graders as they demonstrate responsibility, and stay tuned for a look at how the coronavirus pandemic changes how we are responsible.
I've been responsible by feeding the fish.
I try to remind myself at 8:30 we need to go.
Thank you.
showing that responsibility throughout the whole year. But going into November, we're going to figure out a new word brought to us by Miss Kenyon and Miss Hastings. Take it away, guys.
Hello, Elmonica engineers. We are back and we're excited to introduce November's word of the month. This month, our word is empathy. You might be wondering what empathy means. Well, there are two parts to empathy. First, we need to identify how someone feels. And the second part is understanding their point of view, their perspective, or what they think.
We have a video here with Mark Ruffalo and his friend to explain empathy for you.
Hello, I'm Mark.
And I'm Murray.
And we're here to tell you about the word empathy.
Empathy, yes, empathy.
Tell them about the word empathy. What's wrong?
You're not going to believe this, Mark.
What?
But I can't remember what empathy means.
No, that's okay, that's okay. I'll tell them what empathy means.
Oh, boy! This is so exciting! Mark Ruffalo is going to tell us about empathy! Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy!
Can I do it?
Go, please, go for it, Mark.
All right. Empathy is when you're able to understand and care about how someone else is feeling.
Oh, right. That's what empathy is.
Yes.
I don't get it.
What?
Sorry.
Okay. Let me see if I can explain it to you in some way.
Okay, I'm going to listen.
Let's say I'm walking along and
what?
I stubbed my toe. Oh, that hurts.
Oh, you poor thing,
Murray.
Mark.
Oh, Murray.
That hurts. I can imagine exactly how you feel.
That's empathy.
What's empathy?
You could imagine exactly how I feel. You could understand just how it felt. That's empathy.
I still don't get it.
What?
I still don't get it.
Okay. Let's think of another way.
Okay, let's think of another way. Thinking.
Oh, Murray.
What?
Did I tell you about that time when I lost my favorite teddy bear? It was...
This is very sad. Did you love that teddy bear?
I love that teddy bear.
Oh, I can imagine exactly how you feel. It's really sad feeling. It makes me want to cry like this.
It was sad. It was so sad. But you know what?
What?
You know what empathy is.
I do?
That was empathy.
What?
You could understand how I was feeling, exactly how I was feeling, and understood it. That's empathy.
I get it now. Yes. Yes, I get it.
Yes.
I understand empathy.
You understand empathy, Murray.
I'm so happy right now.
I'm happy too.
It makes me want to dance the dance of happiness.
I can imagine exactly how you feel. I want to dance the dance of happiness too.
So what are we waiting for?
Let's do it.
All right, so our November challenge for you is to show empathy. If you'd like to be featured in next month's assembly, let us know how you've done that. We will share a seesaw or canvas activity for you next month where you can share your response. We can't wait to hear from you.
Oh, so that's what empathy means. The ability to understand and share someone else's feelings. Wow, I'm gonna make my goal this month to be more empathetic to others. And stay tuned, engineers, for ways that you can show empathy to your parents, siblings, classmates, teachers, anyone. It will make the world a better place. Switching gears, I've got a great story for you this week. Miss Kenyon is gonna read it to us, and it's about empathy. How cool is that? It's like it was planned or something. All right, guys, take it away, Miss Kenyon.
Hello, Elmonica friends. It's Mrs. Kenyon, your school counselor. I'm going to read You, Me, and Empathy by Janie Sanders. Enjoy. You, Me, and Empathy by Janie Sanders, illustrated by Sophia Cardoso. When I was a baby, I really was small, while everyone else seemed incredibly tall. But as I grew older, I started to see that people are people just like me. How are you the same as your friend, sister, brother? How are you different? Sometimes I'm happy and sometimes I'm sad. Sometimes I'm worried and sometimes I'm mad. We all have feelings, you have them too. And sometimes I feel just exactly like you. What makes you happy, sad, worried, mad? When my mother was sick with a tummy bug, I knew that she needed a big snuggly hug. I rubbed her back and patted her hand and said, I'm so sorry, I do understand. For once I was sick with a terrible flu. I sneezed and I sputtered, but what could I do? My mother said softly while patting my hand, my dearest of dears, I do understand. That's when she gave me a big snuggly hug, and I instantly knew I was humongously loved. My mother was kind and caring to me, exactly the same as how we should be. Who helps you when you're sick? When my brother fell over and hurt his knee, he cried and cried in front of me. I helped him up and said, there, there, and sat him down on the kitchen chair. For once, when I slipped and cut my knee, my brother was there to care for me. He held my hand and said, there, there, and sat me down on the kitchen chair. One day in the park, a girl was pushed over, knocked to the ground by a dog called Rover. I knew his name because, you see, Rover the dog did the same thing to me. The poor little girl sat still on the ground, not a sob, not a whimper, not one little sound. Then, all of a sudden, she started to cry. Perhaps I could help. It was worth a try. There, there, I said as I patted her arm. Rover the dog doesn't mean any harm. He's just being playful, so try not to fuss. He just doesn't notice small people like us. Have you ever helped someone who was sad? How did you help them? One day at school, while having fun, I saw a boy alone in the sun. No one came over and said, let's play. I could see he was sad. He was not okay. So I left my friends and over I ran. And I asked if he'd like to play in the sand. His smile was huge, enormous, and wide. It gave me a warm, fuzzy feeling inside. When I started school, I too sat alone. I had no one to play with. I longed to go home. Then a girl called Abby ran over to me and asked me to play near the old oak tree. We gathered some acorns for finger hats and swung from the branches like acrobats. We played for ages, and from that day on, friends forever, we always say. Yesterday at the big green slide, I saw a child run away and hide. Come back, said her dad. Just give it a try. This slide is not so terribly high. So up she climbed to the very top. Slide down, he said. I'll help you to stop. But there she sat and there she stayed, wanting to move but too afraid. I knew just how this girl was feeling. Worried and scared, her head was reeling. For when I was little, I sat at the top, terrified that I wouldn't stop. You can do this, is what I said. You're braver than you think. It's all in your head. The more and more brave things you do, the easier it becomes for you. I am really brave, the girl shouted down, and whoosh! Before we knew it, she was on the ground. Have you ever felt scared? What happened? There's one more story I'd like to share about a bully who never played fair. He pushed children over, was mean and unkind. He made us feel sad, so deep down inside. But one day at school, I saw a strange thing. The bully was bullied and pushed off a swing. He was sad. He was crying as he walked away. So I followed and asked him, "Are you okay?" His eyes were watery, his nose was red. He looked at me. These words he said, I was mean to the children, it just wasn't right. I know how they feel now. I've had a big fright. Kind and caring is how we should be. I know this because a bully bullied me. Have you ever been bullied? How did it make you feel? What did you do? So as I am growing taller each day, I'm learning so much in so many ways. I'm learning that we should try to be kind, helpful, and caring all of the time. Our world is so special. We all need to care about one another and the earth we share. People together from far and from wide, We're all on this planet. We're on the same side. What might be some ways we could show other people we care about them? So when someone's hurting or worried or sad, remember those feelings I'm sure you've had. Say kindly with care, "I understand, I do, because sometimes I feel just exactly like you."
Engineers, we only have a couple days of October left, and you know what that means.
I like turtles.
No, I'm not talking about Jonathan the Turtle Kid. I'm talking about we only have a couple days left to be super spooky and do our super spooky dance from GO Noodle. Come on, everyone, stand up. Stand up. Let's get moving.
Spooky party.
Dance. Anyway, friends, our time's coming to a close. I want to wish you guys a safe and happy end of October, and we'll see you next month for our November assembly. Take care now. Bye.